Hi, you guys. I'm a little over from, I mean, closer to this chair because as you can see, the sunlight is like very bright right now, but this is like the best lighting I'm getting in this location in the house. So don't worry, my locations will change very soon. But it is Friday and I am gonna start talking about money. And honestly, you guys, this is gonna be a tough thing for me because I am having some real awareness about my relationship with money and how my relationship has been with money over the years. And it took this long for me to realize how it has really been affecting my life. Like, I've been in situations where, I don't want to face money or I will just spend. It's not just me, it's for me and my husband to manage properly, but we would just spend, we would just jump into things, we wouldn't plan. We never talked about a budget and we've been married 5 years. Never really saved, ne really haven't saved. We just never had conversations about money because I think we both, if you even back to childhood things do affect you when you're an adult, and especially when it comes to money. And I think we both come from families totally different, but families where money was not taught properly. So I will say on my end, my story, for instance, I grew up very well. My dad was very wealthy, still is very wealthy. But I was never taught money directly. And so what I grew up seeing is my family spending. Always been in a big house, always been in nice cars, and that's what I was used to spending. I was never really taught to save. I was never taught about budgeting. I was never taught about planning. I was never taught any of those things. So it was spend, spend, spend. I would get an allowance. Like, I started getting allowance in maybe, I want to say, elementary school, and it was like $100 a week. So that's how I grew up. Just spending nice cars, nice things. I'll ask my dad for something and he would go get it for me. And that's how it was. Up until the whole housing crash thing happened. I think that was back in 2008, and that's when I started to see the effects of not planning and not, like, my dad went from working in the construction biz, making a lot of money, to not being prepared to experienced that because his occupation was in the, home category. So he was affected really bad by that, and I had to see that happen. My parents are self-employed, but they didn't plan, like, the succession of their business, or they didn't have things in place or anything like that. But they're not, not poor, still very well off. Just if they had been prepared at that time, they would be sitting on a lot more wealth right now. They wouldn't have had the setback or whatever. So that's how I grew up. I won't share how my husband grew up. Maybe in another video, he'll share how his childhood was with money. And actually, I never even talked to him about that. So I think that's something that we'll talk about to strengthen our relationship. But yeah, so this video is gonna be my transparency about my relationship with money and just facing the fact that I have to have a budget in place. I have to face my money. I have to tell my money where to go. I have to become besties with my money and not, enemies with my money. And that's how I've always been. I've been afraid of money, afraid of success, afraid of making money, like, on my own as an entrepreneur, and my desires to be an entrepreneur. Just making so many excuses of why I can't do things, and money is always an issue for a lot of things in the past and even now. And God showed me that I had to do something for him to trust me with more money. He had to put that in my spirit. And there's things that you don't want to face in life, and that was something for me. But now I'm just tired. Like, I am tired of being broke. Like, looking like this with this hat and this hair, or you might see other videos with the curly hair. That's how I'm always looking, because the excuse is always, I don't have money to go get my hair done. I don't have money to do this. I don't have money to do that. And I'm tired of saying that. And I'm the only one that can get myself out of this situation. Sometimes whether your husband is on board or not, or your partner, whoever it might be, whether they're on board or not, you have to want to make the change first yourself. And that's where I am. I am currently in student loans alone. I have $46,000 in student loans. And get this, this is the kicker. No degree. Don't ask me how. I'll do a video about that another day. $46,000 in student loans and no degree. I'm supposed to have like a bachelor's degree right now, maybe two, something like that, but I don't. And it's learning lessons. It was my choices, my decisions, just my mindset. It's just, right now where I am in my life, it's just showing me how I was and what I need to change. So that's the biggest debt that I have. And then there's other smaller debts, credit card debt. Thank God it's not thousands of dollars. But I do have debt, and my husband, and what, my debt is my husband's debt is mine, and we have to do things to fix it. We're just tired of being broke. We're tired of making excuses. We're tired of telling our kid, my kid, oh, we don't have the money right now, whatever. And we know that if we want to start leaving good financial, a good financial foundation, we have to start now. We can't keep saying, oh, this and oh, woe is me and oh, we'll, whatever. Just it's time to stop making excuses. So, my money glow up. This is what I'm calling it, my money glow up. This is my year to just really dive in and just pray and always seek God for his guidance in this and give me the knowledge that I need and then give me the wisdom to apply the knowledge and really commit, because managing your money is something. Like, money is the root of all evil, they always say. Yeah, and it is. I mean, you could be dead broke, you could be rich and still have problems and stuff like that, but it's how you manage it. And that's where I am. So this right here, excuse the lighting, this is my budget planner. This is new to me, you guys. Like, this is so new to me. And after binging, that's all I've been doing for the past 2 weeks, is binging on budgeting videos, how to set up a budget binder or planner, getting out of debt, like just different systems to try. Increasing income is definitely another thing that I have to work on, because right now we're on one income and it's not a lot of income. And I have many talents, but just because I make excuses and I've realized that I was afraid of success, that's not going to allow me to make money. It's my mindset. And honestly, I just watched a video by, oh, I think her name is Gia. Her channel is Marriage and Motherhood. I love her channel because her main thing is talking about debt. And she just posted a video today for her Debt Free Friday video. And it's about breaking the cycle of being broke. And she talks about how, your mindset and how things can come from your childhood. Also, you should do affirmations. Instead of saying, oh, I can't buy this, just say, I don't have the money right now to buy it. Just changing little things like that. And I realized that that's what it takes for me. So I've been just really diving in, and I think I've been doing good so far. I designated one day to working on finances, but I realize if you're just starting out and you're a newbie and you really want to commit to this thing, you're gonna have to do something every day to get used to checking on your money. For instance, checking bank accounts every day. Even if you don't have money in there, you have to get in the habit of checking bank accounts, these extra fees and all this stuff, and even cutting down on expenses. Like, that's where we are. So this has been my friend every day. Every penny I spend now is being tracked. All the income that goes out for monthly is being tracked. And I'm working on like different systems. Like, for instance, as we're going to work on increasing our income first, and then we're going to do like the snowball debt payoff, which is Dave Ramsey, which is very popular on YouTube. There's so many videos, the envelope system, the debt snowball payoff, or in his Financial Peace University, which I am going to hopefully invest in soon. So this binder I bought from Target, and I've actually had this binder sitting in my closet for like, I don't know, I want to say a year maybe, maybe longer. And see, that's one of the habits. I would just spend money. Don't budget anything, don't plan anything, just spend. And Target will do that to you. The dollar spot will just always go in Target and spending and stuff sitting around. But ultimately, I had a use for it. So this is now the budget binder for my family. until I can afford one of those good fancy ones. And what I, and I bought, also bought inserts from the dollar spot that I just had sitting around, of course. Inserts, I'm gonna label these. I actually have written right here like what I'm gonna label them as, which is debts, expenses, bills tracker, income tracker, budget, spending tracker, savings, yearly expenses. Like, you have to keep track of all that stuff. You have to really pay attention to where your money is going. And I will honestly say I've been paying way more attention to like spending on a daily basis. We haven't really been doing it because money has been very tight, but if we have a little extra money, like our problem is spending on eating out and coffee. And even though I have coffee at home, see, those are the habits. I could just make coffee at home. But just because we're out, it's like, oh my God, let me go to Wawa because I love Wawa's coffee. Let's go get one. And that's what it's been. So just tracking, you have to know where every penny goes. So yeah, that's what I've been tracking. But these I'm using for just notes and kind of different YouTubers that I like, and just different ideas and tips that I find, expenses and stuff like that, stuff that I will eventually add to the planner. Of course, I have these sticky notes. But in this section, how I'm starting out, because I'm a beginner, I'm actually using these calendar pages here, and they're not numbered or lettered or in, like, they're not already filled in, so I have to go in and fill them in. So what I did was like just wrote down all the paydays, and then I would write out the bills that are going to be due every week. So like you see electric here, paydays and stuff like that. So I'm writing down what's going to be due, and then in this section I, like here, this is where I write down what's been spent every day. This is the spending tracker pages. And then I use one of these sheets for a new week, and I write down the pay cycle, which is from payday to the next payday, what is going to have to come out of that check. And that's how I'm doing that for now. So this is how I'm setting it up. So this is February, and I'm actually about to sit down and go over February's budget. So no, I can't do a budget video for you. I don't think I'll be able to do that until about March or April, when I feel like, okay, I got it going. So now I can do a video of how it's working out for me. But you guys, this really is to just track my journey of, you know, my finances. I guess I'll come back with another video about like what I'm going to use the different tabs for, because I'm not sure yet, because I'm new to it. So I can't tell you like what exactly I'm going to be using it for, but, very cheap, like doing things on a budget. Yes, you have all the Erin Condren's. You can go get a happy planner. Of course. I mean, if you have it in your budget to buy a happy planner for half off, then do that. Because I think eventually that's what I'll do once I, you know, get the hang of having a budget and increasing my income. And then I'll go invest in a planner, a better planner for my finances. But until then, you got to do what you got to do. So this was $3 at the Target dollar spot. And then this whole set of tabs and stickies and stuff, it comes in a pack for $3 too. So there you have it. A planner for $6, and you can do what you want with it. It gives you the opportunity to play around with it and make it work for you. And I also have this budget book, Recollections from Michaels. I actually had a really good friend of mine give me this. She gave me this like 2 years ago, and it was just sitting around because, once again, like I said, I know nothing about a budget. So budgeting a month in advance was something new for me, so I didn't really do it right for January. But I am going to do for February. And at first I was like, man, I can't do a monthly budget, like a week out. But now I see that now that I've been working in my binder, I can do that. So Michaels, of course, Michaels has these. Michaels is always having a sale, 40, 50% off. So, I'll probably come back to you guys and talk about like how I did a monthly budget. I'm also going to share who I'm watching on YouTube to get most of my ideas. I actually found a couple people that I really like to watch that are really good with it. So I'll share those sometimes. But I'm going to share my journey because I am about, you know, me and my husband combined, we're probably about $60,000 or $70,000 in debt. And we have to do something about it. And we can't keep making excuses. Like, this is not the life that I want to have for my children. And I'm just tired of being broke. I'm tired of saying, like, no, I don't have this and I don't have that. I can't do this. I can't do that. You know I have to change my mindset, and words are powerful. So I have to start speaking life into my finances. But you also have to speak life into your partner, your husband, or whoever is doing it with you. But you also have to pour into yourself and motivate yourself to do these things. And you guys, I'm like, I am tired. I am in debt and I want to get out and I want to control my money and I want to set a good foundation right now for my children. I'm not going to say better late than never, but better now than never. Now is definitely the time. And especially with the way that the world is going today, you don't know, like, what's in store for us, especially now that we have a new president. You just don't know. And I think it's good. I know it's good to always be prepared, especially financially. And I was just reading a blog post, an article earlier today that's saying, like, millennials, which is me, like, you know, the average, like, I forgot how much, it like 9 out of 10 millennials don't have a savings with at least $500 in it. And emergency funds and everything is so important. Like, you can't just do things on a whim if you're not rich. You have to be prepared. You have to be planning. You have to have a cushion. And that's so important. But my finances they're not going to only include, like, budgeting and spending tracker and expense tracker. It's also going to include things like putting an estate plan into play, getting a will, making sure I have the proper life insurance, make sure we have proper health insurance. Because everything, more things than you know, affects your money. So you just have to make sure you be prepared all the way around, not just, oh, I have a budget, oh, I'm saving, oh, I know where my money is going. That's not enough. You have to make sure you also have a full foundation, I guess I would say, not a half foundation. So that's where I am. This is my first, I would call it my money glow up, because that's what it's all about. It's all about increasing my income, paying off my debt, and just getting where I need to be. And the excuse was always, too, I just didn't want to put in the work. So not only did I make excuses and not want to face the problem, I was always putting, you know, like, just not willing to work. Like, I didn't want to commit to it. And just, you know how it is. Everybody has been there. Everybody is not, you know, fortunate enough to learn from their parents, but that's no excuse once you become an adult. If you're aware of the problem and that you're broke, only you can do something about it. You can't keep blaming other people. You can't keep blaming your parents. You can't blame this person or that person. It's you. It's up to you to do something, and then you bring people on board. And everybody is not meant to understand what you're doing, and everybody's not meant to understand your journey. So if you want to keep being in debt, Crystal, talking to myself, because I'm like, we're in like $70,000 worth of debt, and more than half of that is my student loans alone with no degree. Like, it makes no sense to me. And I know you watching this will be like, she got $46,000 and no degree. Like, what do you have going on? Just young and careless, and nobody in my ear giving me the right knowledge in the right direction, and not a strong foundation. And that's what happens sometimes. But I can't keep making excuses, and I can't keep blaming. If I want my life to change, I have to do something, and I am tired of being broke. So this is the journey of my money glow up. And I hope you guys will join me. I'm going to commit to this. And this video is just to show my journey. This is where I'm starting. So this is where I'm starting. I'm $70,000 in debt. And by the end of the year, I don't know what my goal is right now, but I'll share that later. But by the end of the year, it will not be $70,000 in debt. So until next time, you guys. Yeah, this is where I am. This is where I am. The glow up is real, and there are some things that I have to face that I don't want to face, but it's necessary. So until next time, I will try to do a money video next Friday. If not, it will be every other Friday. But you can follow me on Instagram at the Mommy Glow Up. I'll be posting things there as I go along. But you'll see me maybe next Friday. So remember, you can't pour from an empty cup. Remember to affirm yourself. Remember to love yourself, especially if you're a mom. You have to be there 100% for your kids. So starting with you, with the self-care and all that good stuff, it starts with you. Nobody is happy if mom is not happy, if mom is not glowing. So until the next Money Glow Up video, I will see you guys.